Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on operations on graphs. There are several operations that can be performed on the graphs. The main important operations performed on the graphs are, first one is union operation, second one is intersection operation, third one is symmetric difference operation, fourth one is decomposition operation, and fifth one is complement operation, and the sixth one is deletion operation. So these are the main important operations that can be performed on the graphs. Okay, in that one, the first operation is union operation. So the union operation can be explained with this example. Okay, consider two graphs, that is a G1 graph and this is a G2 graph. Okay, so graph G1 contains the vertex set V1 is equal to set of V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5, and edge E1 refers to the edge set. So V1 to V2, V2 to V3, V3 to V4, V4 to V5, V5 to V1, V1 to V4, V4 to V2. So, wait. 48. Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on operations on graphs. In the previous videos, we are already discussed about various types of graphs. Approximately 25 graphs are explained in the previous videos. Now we go for operations on graphs. So there are several operations that can be performed on the graphs. So mainly there are 6 operations that can be performed on the graphs, that are 6 important operations are, first one is union operation, second one is intersection operation, third one is symmetric difference operation, fourth one is decomposition operation, fifth one is deletion operation, and sixth one is complement operations. So these are the main important 6 operations that can be performed on the graphs. Okay, so first operation is union operation. So let us consider we are taking 2 graphs, G1 and G2. So G1 is equal to V1 comma E1 and G2 is equal to V2 comma E2. Okay, now the union operation can be explained with this example. Okay, so consider the graphs G1 and G2, that is already described. G1 contains the V1 comma E1, where V1 is the vertex set. So the vertex set contains in G1 is V1, V2, V3, V4 and V5, and edge set E1 contains in G1 is V1 comma V2, V2 comma V3, V3 comma V4, V4 comma V5, V5 comma V1, V1 comma V4, V4 comma V2. Okay, now consider graph G2. G2 contains the vertex set V2 and edge set E2. V2 contains the set of vertices V1, V2, V3, V4 and V6, and edge set E2 contains V1 comma V2, V2 comma V6, V6 comma V3, V3 comma V4, V4 comma V1, V1 comma V3, V2 comma V3 and V2 comma V4. Okay, now the union of G1 and G2 is denoted by G1 union G2 is equal to V1 comma V1 union V2 and E1 union E2. So union of vertex set in both G1 and G2, that is equal to V1 union V2. Union of adjacent in both the graphs G1 and G2 is nothing but E1 union E2. Okay, so the union of G1 and G2 is denoted by G1 union G2 is equal to V1 union V2. That is nothing but set of vertices in both the graphs. Okay, E1 union E2, the set of edges in both the graphs G1 and G2. Okay, so here union of V1 union V2 is equal to V1 union V2 is equal to set of what are the vertices in V1 in graph G1, that is V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Union, what are the vertices in V2? That is V1, V2, V3, V4, V6. Okay, so union is nothing but, okay, duplicate elements or any duplicate elements are will appear only once. So V1 is appear two times, so only one time we are writing. Next, V2 appear two times, we are writing only one time. V3 appear two times, we are writing only one time. V4 appear two times, we are writing only one time. V5 appeared only one time, we are writing this one. V6 appeared only one time, we are writing this one. Okay, so that is the union of V1 union V2 contains the vertices set V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. Yes, V1, V2, V3, V4, V5 and V6. Okay, and also adjacent in the same way E1 union E2. Okay. So, this is the union of G1 and G2. Here, V1 is appeared in both the graphs. We can take the vertex set V1. Next, V2 appeared both the graphs. You can take V2. Next, V6 appeared only graph G2. This is also we are taking. V5 is appeared only in graph G1. We are taking. V4 is appeared in both the graphs, I am taking only one time. V3 appeared in both the graphs, I am taking only one time. Okay, now V1 to V2 edge here is there, here also is there. We are writing only one time, V1 to V2. Next one, V1 to V5 edge here is there, but here V5 vertex is not there. We are taking only one time, that is V1 to V5. Next, V5 to V4. Okay, here V5 is not there. So, V5 to V4, I am taking only one time. Next, V3 to V4. Here it is V3 to V4 also there in both the graphs. I am taking only one time. Next, V3 to V6. Here V6 is not there. So, V3 to V6, I am taking V3 to V6 edge. Next one, V2 to V3. Here is there. And here is also is there. I am taking only one time. Next, V1 to V3. Here V1 to V3 is there. But here V1 to V3 is not there. I am taking V1 to V3. Next, V1 to V4. So here V1 to V4 is there. Here V1 to V4 is there. I am taking only one time. Next, V2. Okay. This is the union of graph G1 and G2. We are taking all the vertices in G1 and G2 and we are taking all the edges in G1 and G2. Okay, whatever the vertices in G1 and whatever the vertices in G2, so G1 union G2, all the vertices in G1 and G2 graph is there in G1 union G2. Next, whatever the vertices in G1 and whatever the vertices in G2, all the edges in G1 and G2 is also there in G1 union G2. Okay, so by performing the union operation between these two graphs, okay, this is the resultant operation. This is the union of these two graphs. The resultant graph is this one after performing the union operation between G1 and G2. Okay, next one. Second operation is intersection operation. Okay, so let us consider these two graphs G1 and G2. G1 contains V1, E1. G2 contains V2, E2. The intersection between these two graphs is denoted by G1 intersection G2. Okay, G1 intersection G2 is equal to V1 intersection V2, E1 intersection E2. That means common vertices in both the graphs and common edges in both the graphs, that we are considered in G1 and intersection G2. Okay, what are the common vertices in vertex at V1 and vertex at V2? Okay, what are the common vertices here? V1 is common in between the two graphs, and also V2 is common in between the two graphs, and V4 is also there, common in two graphs. And one next one, V3 is also there in two graphs, but V6 only there in G2 graph, it is not there in G1 graph. V5 is there in G1 graph and V5 is not there in G2 graph. Okay, so that V5 and V6 are eliminated, because V6 appeared only in G2 graphs and V5 is appeared in only G1 graph. So after eliminating V5 and V6, what are the remaining vertices? V1, V2, V3, V4. That is appeared in G1 intersection G2. Okay, V1, V2, V3, V4. Next, what are the common edges between these four vertices? Okay, here V1 to V4 is there. Okay, here also V1 to V4 is there. So now we are writing V1 to V4 edge. Next one, V1 to V2 edge here is there. Here V1 to V2 edge here is there. So common edge V1 to V2 we are writing. Next one, V2 to V3 here is there in G1. V2 to V3 edge here is also there in G2. Write in V2 to V3. Next one, V2 to V4 edge here is there and V2 to V4 edge here is there. So common edge between V2 to V4 is also there in G1 and G2. So we are writing V2 to V4. Okay, so this is the intersection between the two graphs G1 and G2. Okay, so this is the resultant graph. This resultant graph is nothing but the intersection between the two graphs. That is intersection between the vertex set in two graphs, V1 intersection V2, and intersection between the edge set in two graphs, E2, E1 intersection E2. So this is the resultant graph. So this graph is the union operation performed on G1 and G2. The resultant union operation graph is this one. This graph is intersection between the two graphs. So this is the resultant graph. Intersection between common vertices and common edges between the two graphs. This is the resultant graph. Union means, okay, combination. Combination of both the vertex set and both the edge sets in two graphs. So this is the resultant graph. Okay.